welcome back. As you know, on Twitter, on YouTube, on everywhere else, I've hyped an awesome project I've been working on. It's steampunk, obviously. And I have been working with Airship Bendis on an awesome video, and it's coming to you guys shortly. So make sure that you check my channel, and you also check Airship Bendis' channel as well on YouTube, and you'll be able to see that video soon. Thanks!
Hi, my name is Marcible, the musical automaton.
Hi, I'm Sage Coppervine, and I am a steampunk satyr.
Well, this here is Piqua.
Piqua.
And Piqua is an underfey who serves as my bodyguard.
Piqua.
Hi, I'm Judge from Steamworks and Shadows, the web series. And I'm a badass.
I am Steampunk Vader. May the steam be with you.
My name, I'm Layla Anders. I'm the navigator of the Airship Bendis.
Well, I found out about it when I learned about steam-powered giraffe last May.
Well, it's kind of a natural evolution out of, we were doing some steampunk stuff for a while, and my husband and I are leather workers, and I've always been super into fairy lore and fairy things, and particularly satyrkin. So the easiest way for me to be comfortable in steampunk land was to have a satyr.
Back in 2008, my wife and I discovered steampunk online, and it was getting close to Halloween, so we decided to do steampunk for Halloween, and that was the first costume in steampunk I ever made, which was an alchemist crossed with a Ghostbuster. And actually, there's a picture that she took of me that went online and has gone viral without credit.
Oh no!
But you could see a picture of me with this gas mask pointing a pistol up, and there's like this big kind of bluish-green lantern above me and a big red door. If you just search steampunk, I'm in the first couple pages.
I have actually enjoyed the aesthetic before I realized it had a name. I've always loved Victorian fashion and just the Victorian era in general. And I love science fiction. I love things that are fantastical and maybe a little creepy. And you would see images and things on the internet and different various, you know, pop culture and even like old fictional stories that had to do with, it was like this Victorian science fiction. And I always loved it. And then later on learned that it had a name, steampunk. And so we began to get into it via costuming probably 3 years ago, 4 years ago, I think, was our first attempt at costumes for steampunk characters. And then it just grew into this.
Well, the main thing is this vest that you know, I just thought it looked very Victorian, steampunk, steam-powered giraffe, kind of rolled it all in one. I have just a simple undershirt, gloves, just added these wrist bracelets, whatever, for lack of a better term, last night. Just have some pinstripe pants, regular shoes. I have just added this today as well. I've got a few new things on me today. The hat is new. I started out with one that actually had a red flower here, which, if I don't know if this is going to be linked to like the steampunk vault videos or anything or pictures, but you'll see the old hat in that poster. I have my umbrella that I did use a couple times today.
In the rain? So,
exactly, and got wet in the process, but that's the point.
And how long did it take you to get your makeup done this morning, or for you to do your makeup this morning?
Well, 2.5 hours, and that's down from 4 hours when I first started. Obviously, I'm getting a little more used to it, plus I've also, it took me, you know, several times of doing this to kind of figure out what I wanted my look to be. It's always been kind of based off of Rabbit from Steam-Powered Giraffe, because it just had like the best look about it, I guess. I could probably actually do it in 2 hours. I took my time a little bit today because I was going to be in video and stuff, but so I'm happy that I've cut the time down for sure.
Gotcha. So looking at your feet, you have your satyr feet.
Yes.
And your satyr legs.
Yes.
And then what about the rest of your costume? What's the different pieces?
The dress, honestly, is one of those things that I've had for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I got it at a fairy festival somewhere. The belt is
utilitarian and is actually in the process of getting more things added to it to hold things like wands and canes and my panpipes that I have on me at the moment. And it also gives me pockets because women's clothes don't have pockets. vest, I don't remember, the find somewhere. And then the harness is something that my husband and I built, and it lives on top of a lot of my costumes and matches the top hat that I wear a lot with my smaller horn.
All right, so can you walk me through your costume? Explain all of the little different bits and pieces and how long it took to get this to how it is today.
Well, I'm a monster hunter, so everything on this costume has to do with hunting monsters and, well, killing them, catching them, whatever I gotta do. The process of this costume has been about 2 to 3 years of collecting pieces, modifying pieces, adding pieces, and just generally working on the costume consistently. In fact, this is the newest edition of the costume that was different from even just a month ago. So we have leather and brass armor that was all hand done, except for the vest, and some automaton fingers and a communicator. We have a leather harness system that holds up a lot of my accessories. A good Western gun belt with a regular Colt and also the hole gun because it makes holes in things. And then down here we have some thigh armor with some additional accessories like my fairy handcuffs, my Edward's ashes, my dragon tail, lycanthropy cure, and my electric torch and some leprechaun cuffs.
Perfect.
And then of course, goggles because it's steampunk.
Perfect. My costume is made from bed sheets and upholstery vinyl and old clock parts and hardware pieces. For the character, the headpiece serves to enhance her abilities. She helps to navigate the airship through space and time, and she has some psychic essence sort of powers, and it helps her to hone them among other purposes.
Well, I kind of had the idea that I wanted to do something for a couple of months, and then all of a sudden last October, probably within a couple of weeks, I was like, I'm gonna do this. And I just kind of threw stuff together. My vest came, and I, of course, my suit's been modified since then, but my vest came and I had the makeup and things just kind of came together.
Consciously, I guess it's probably been about 4 years or so, but steampunk was one of those things that just kind of naturally evolved into our life. Like having come out of a lot of alternative cultures and fairy cultures and things like that, as steampunk came up on the rise, I didn't fall into it on purpose, if that makes any sense. Like, I didn't mean to go out and make a steampunk character. I've barely actually purposely acquired anything for the purpose of steampunk. Most of it is just in my wardrobe. And then a couple of years ago, we did this out in mid-Missouri. They did this tiny little pirate steampunk festival at Gloucester Castle, and we went out there, and that was the first time we met all of the Airship Bendis folks. And we all just kind of talked to each other, and then it was about a year later that we all started talking to each other more, and then they asked us if we would come out and participate in the web series, initially as smaller extra parts, and we ended up with parts that ended up being a little bit larger. I play one of the Veritas villains who hasn't been revealed yet. And my husband ended up being the Hand of Glory, is Adrian Colt's right-hand man, or left-hand man, as it were, but he's his lieutenant. And then, I don't know, the universe said, you all are supposed to spend a bunch of time together, and they just started taking us with them all over the place. And so now we travel, we still do our own independent business on our own, but we travel with the airship and doing steampunk stuff a lot.
And then in 2011, there was an outdoor festival that said it was a pirate steampunk festival, and I decided to make a new costume, which turned out to be the start of this costume. And through that experience, I gained a bunch of friends that were interested in steampunk, and they kind of came together. We made an airship, and now we have a web series, and we have costumes that we just keep adding onto, and now we're staple characters that people actually recognize, and it's completely surreal.
Well, I'm having a lot of fun with it. I mean, if you like old Victorian era type stuff or old West, whatever fits into the 1800s genre. But you also like the new age stuff, you know, I just think it's a perfect mix and you can have a lot of fun with it.
Perfect.
I think that a lot of people are maybe a little intimidated by what they see, you know, first off, like, 'cause sometimes the costumes are very involved and people get very elaborate and they think, you know, there is no right or wrong way to do steampunk. It's a fictional alternate reality. If somebody says that's not steampunk, they don't listen to them. If you think it's steampunk and you like it, then do it. You know, there are a lot of people who, the fairy steampunk crossover, some people, that's not steampunk. Well, why not? You know, steampunk's anything that you really want it to be, you know. I mean, it's a cool alternate reality. I like the verse, but don't think that just because, you know, well, I don't have the $300 corset, and I don't have the $200, you know, mechanical arm, and I don't have a pair of goggles that you can't do it. Put on whatever you want. Go hunting at a thrift store. If you like your character, that's all that matters.
Steampunk is Victorian science fiction. Anything set in the Victorian era or around that time, with a science fiction or fantasy or anything that goes beyond normal, anything that goes beyond history the way it was, would be considered the punk aspect. So things that didn't actually exist during that time. And you get a little bit of steampunk in a lot of current TV shows and movies and just all kinds of stuff. And we go a lot farther than what Hollywood does, and we're a lot more overt in our steampunkiness. But if you just look at antiquity with advanced technology, you can find steampunk.
People who aren't familiar with steampunk should know that it's awesome and they should join us and play. There are so many awesome elements to the culture, to just the genre. It's beautiful. There's so many creative people. There's so many creative people that get involved in it, and so there's just really neat people to meet as far as, you know.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed all of the interviews that I did with the Airship Vendus folks. Next up, you're going to see the actual steampunk video that I was able to do with them when we shot in this awesome location in Wichita, Kansas. So make sure you check out Airship Vendus's channel for behind the scenes and more information related to the entire project. Thanks, guys.
Wait, what are you doing? That needs to be set on channel 7.
Which one?
The one with the dial on it.
Oh, that one?
Would you hurry up already? You could be here any minute.
Well, I'm trying to get a fix on our exact location. If I don't, it could be bad.
Yeah? How bad is bad?
Not that bad. Although, it could result in a singularity and the entire human race could be destroyed. Oh.
Right. That's bad. Thanks, robot.
You to Fairy. Come out where I can see you. Don't be afraid.
It's time to go. You're the only one.
Almost got it. Just a little bit more.
about time you got back with... Who's that?
Darkness covered in shine. Can't fight the sparkle. She's the one you need.
What are you talking about? I told you to find the doc.
Shenanigans!
Wait.
You've traveled through a rift in time and space, maybe trip a little shorter. You're not really who we were looking for, but Layla decided you needed to be here instead.
We can't keep yammering like this. He's gonna find us any second. Oh, crap. He's right behind me, isn't he?
Affirmative, Judge. The villain is right behind. Interest you in a song. You didn't have to look my way.
Where are those crystals you intercepted?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I will tear this town apart until I find those crystals.
You needed a little sparkle. Why do you bad guys always wear black? You need a little bit of pink to that outfit.
Infinite child. I'm covered in glitter. No.